Welcome, Grade 8, to your first online English lesson, a very first for all of us. Today we will have a look at the different parts of speech, starting off with the different nouns. The proper nouns, pronouns, common nouns, compound nouns, abstract nouns, and collective nouns. These are your subheadings. I will tell you when exactly to write them down. Later on in the lesson, we will also have a look at verbs and prepositions. First step is to write today's date, the 20th of April. The heading is Term 2 Language Revision. Step 2, write the word nouns large over two lines. Now use a highlighter or color pen and circle the N in the word nouns. Step 3, write the word names and circle the N in the word names. It should look like the example below. Every item, person, street or building has a name. Names are important and here are some reasons. Your first subheading is proper nouns. Write the subheading proper nouns. Did you notice the word proper? The definition of the word proper reads as follows: belonging or relating exclusively to. Think of the following for a while. Your parents found out that they were expecting a baby. That baby is you. They wanted to give you a proper name. Some parents decided on a unique name, others on a family name. But it took some time and thought, choosing a proper name for you. Now, write down your name and surname, the name of the school that you attend, the name of the closest hospital, the name of the street where you stay. Did you notice all proper nouns start with a capital letter? Highlight or circle all the capital letters in the above. Your second subheading is pronouns. Write down the following. Pronouns sometimes replace proper nouns. Notice that both of the words start with the letters PR. That is how you should remember it. A few examples. He, they, them, she, we, and I. Charles and Charlie are proper nouns. These names could be replaced by the word they, which is a pronoun. Your third subheading is common nouns. Highlight or circle the word common. Common nouns refer to common everyday items. Think about a grocery list. How would your mom or dad make a list of items they need if these items did not have names? How would you write down your wish list for Christmas if the items your heart desired did not have names? Now, let's create a list of common nouns. Remember, a list is words that are written below one another. Write down 10 items. Make sure you do not write down the name of the item. A phone is a common noun, but a Samsung is the name of the phone, and that makes it a proper noun. Your fourth subheading is compound nouns. A compound word is made up of two or more words to create a new word. As new inventions are created, we require new names for these inventions. It's one word plus another to create a new word. Some examples. Tooth plus paste is toothpaste. Six plus pack is six pack. Bed plus room is bedroom. And tennis plus shoe creates the word tennis shoe. Note the following. Some words create one new word, while other words are hyphenated, and others remain two separate words, but create a new meaning. Now it's your turn. Write down 10 compound nouns using the same format as above. Your fifth subheading is abstract nouns. An abstract noun is an idea, quality, or state. It refers to feelings. You cannot place it in a box, and you can only experience it. Some examples: happiness, truth, danger, love, and friendship. Now it's your turn. Write down 10 abstract nouns. The sixth subheading is collective nouns. Highlight or circle the word collect. The definition of collect is as follows: to gather a number of things. If your best friend tells you that he or she is collecting games, you will expect a variety of games to play when you go to visit them. If I tell you that I collect cars, I should obviously own more than one. Collective nouns are more than one. Now here is the challenge. The more you read and the more you listen for information attentively, the more collective nouns you will know. Complete the following collective nouns. Now we have completed the nouns. The next part of speech we look at is verbs. Verbs are doing words. A definition: a word used to describe an action. Below are a few examples of different verbs. Write down 10 verbs of your own. Your next part of speech is prepositions. Highlight or circle the word position found in the word prepositions. Preposition tells you the position of an object or item. A few examples: above, among, below, down, across, around, beneath, under, against, before, beside, upon, along, behind, between. And at the bottom, a few pictures to illustrate. This brings us to the end of our first online lesson. I would like you to read chapter 1 in your novel Gulliver's Travels. You will find the questions in the back of the novel based on chapter 1. Please complete the questions in the back of your script. Write the date and the heading novel Gulliver's Travels, chapter 1. Thank you.